So, we're with the surface again. So what do I do with this guy? I have no idea. Today, well, it's actually been, what, two, 3 days now since I last worked on it. And that's the situation. Not heating up or anything like that. And I haven't really worked on this unit. Had a time off, had a bit of relaxing time. The question is, what do we do? The buttons are like that. That's for a different model. Should still be same, eh? Let me pull the one out of the one that it came with. Surface, the body of the surface. The guy, the owner of Winifix website, is kind of angry at me for requesting BIOS fixes. It's probably not required, which is kind of good because the way he helps or gives advice is kind of like a wake-up call. Hey, I think you're doing it the wrong way. What you want is not the answer, etc., etc. So that's how I'm taking it into positive account. Alright, multimeter in voltage mode, so let's have a quick look. What we can do, what we can check. See if it's still looping, 5 volts coming and going. So this is the problem. So with this power button, it doesn't go in a loop. Okay. He does come on. He only comes on to 0.32. That's interesting. Is it staying at that? Interesting. This is definitely interesting. Stuck at 0.23. Stuck on 0.3, I think problem may be somewhere here. 3.3. RAM turns off immediately. There's no battery. 3.3. I want to pay attention to here. Okay, here. So how are we going to pay attention there? We're using this file here. So let's have a look. V core is stuck at 0.3. Remember that one? Remember that was three, that had a really low resistance. Let me check the resistance of that. Okay, so if it's not sharp enough, clear for you, just like that. All right, so what we'll do, we'll cut the power. Why is it stuck on 0.3? Resistance. So these are the two we're interested in. So they go through. Let's have a look at the layout. So there's a capacitor, two giant capacitor. MPK, no, MPK. Okay, it's actually 86.92. I know that one. Okay. So this one, the resistance to ground, 9 ohms, which is same as checking on the coil, which is there. Nine ohms. Forty-five ohms. Tricky indeed. No problem, these guys, these capacitors. What is the problem with these guys? 86902. I've got them, no problem. What if there is nothing wrong with these? What if it's just a BIOS? Son of a mongrel BIOS. You know what? Let's go and try another BIOS file. Let's get a different chip altogether as well. It wouldn't hurt to try. Alright, so I've got some chips here. Let me see which one will be compatible. Okay, so I've got shit. Dropped one. Where are ya? Gotcha. So I've got 2, 4, 6, 8 BIOS chips here. So we're gonna use something 25Q 128. Can't remember which one I will need. BJVQ, okay. That's a 64. So different MXIC, we don't want that. 64. Yep, this is the exact one we're looking for. Can't go wrong with that guy. Okay. Let's go ahead and program a new chip from Winifix, one of the ones I requested earlier from them. Okay. Thank you. So let's first go to Winifix website, where I nearly got banned. Build 7121, okay. Okay, great. Yes, all right, 7121. And I'm assuming the BIOS chips I tried before didn't work because that capacitor wasn't in properly. What do you think? You know, the one that was standing up? So all this time wasted for nothing. If this works, then basically we're gonna have a touchscreen issue. So I don't even know what's on it, so I'm just going to take a dump. Okay, so this is an unknown BIOS. Let's make a folder called unknown. All right, open. All right, and write. Start writing. Okay, that's done. Oh, sorry. Okay, so there we go. Let's put the new chip in. This has to be a not a good installation, horrible at best. Okay. Okay, here we go. It's definitely being pressed. We probably have the same voltage readout. Okay, we don't. So I tried shorting the pins manually. This doesn't feel right. That is very strange. Oh, that's correct, okay. Okay. See here in this BIOS, it does turn off. He does not come on. So these three come on. He comes on. He did come on briefly. That's the backlight. One volt. All right, I'm going to resort to using manual power injection, see what happens. Definitely not that many volts. Zero point eight, all right. So power is currently live. Question is that a normal behavior? Okay. This is not normal. Nah, definitely a problem. So interesting. I would like to see this on the thermal camera. I've never seen such a behavior before. So 0.6. That is so weird. This side has, that side doesn't. Oh, there we go. How the hell do you find what is not getting hot? Okay, so this is really super duper mooper looper tricky. So under the thermal camera, I'm gonna remove that coil. Okay, while that's going on, I'll just check the resistance. Here to ground, 7 ohms. Here to ground, 7 ohms. So this way comes out of this chip, comes out. So that could be the, you know when you look at the coil, like that's the input and that's the output. Okay. But let's see where. So we don't care about the heat for now. Just want to see which side is going to take that beautiful 0.8 volts. CPU side. Okay. So let's have a look at that coil while the board is kind of cooling down. Okay, so we're here. This side, GT1SW goes to here. Okay, and this side, let me double check. Let me see if I'm looking at the right. Slightly different. So what I'm going to do, get another PCB. This guy. So these guys are missing, and then it comes down to here, okay. Whereas here goes into here, which, interestingly, has much higher resistance. Cool. And here goes into here first, capacitor. here into here, vCore in. Into here, into that capacitor, so it's either something to do with that, or this guy maybe not playing well. Let's see. Sync core. Temperature core, CS core. Okay, let me double check. Now it's cooled down a little bit. So the resistance readings, of the legs, so the left side which goes to the CPU, that's the resistance, 9.2 mega, and that's the right side which is 13 ohms. I think I can finally see the CPU getting warm. Okay, that's correct. Let me bring another surface. I have a couple of dead ones. Same. So that's actually okay then. Nothing to worry then. It's perfectly fine. So it's just CPU turning on. Okay, so let's ignore ignore the let's ignore that coil and our RAM. It's all right. It's the battery. That's the maybe I'll touch the ground. Okay, that's fine. That was 3.3. Okay. Pretty much normal. Yeah, answer is I don't know. Let's look at this guy. He's everywhere. Let's find a place to put 3 volts on it. Where will be a nice exposed area? Yeah, I guess here is fine. Now let me check resistance. So let's go have a look on the microscope. Here. And we are in resistance mode. Okay. That's okay. They're all in the same line. Yeah. All system power good signal. Ouch. Okay. What is the resistance reading here? Okay. Let's get a voltage reading of here. Without turning it on. Try and short the pins. Just check my ground is good. Yep, okay. Then I'll use the external connector power. Alright, the button is finally broken. Okay, I've got to put that coil back. Shit, one second. Okay. Power button works, okay. The power good comes on for a short time. And then says, no, power is not good, shut down. Okay. VCCST power good, VCCST CPU. U3401. All right, so will it hurt to randomly? Yeah, it's not of me usually to randomly change parts, but I am going to just make sure this coil is in. Okay, all right. So let's replace that one, MPS K01, for no reason at all, okay? And then we'll also replace this guy, and then we'll replace these two guys. No reason at all, alright? Okay. It's 2, 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6. Okay. That's all fine. Alright, let's see how the chip behaves. Okay, let's bring the charger in. Okay, charger is in. Okay, let's see. No, nothing yet. Still very hot. Okay. Still the same. We are in voltage mode, so have a quick look at say VCC, nothing in the main voltage line, it's still in. And our 3 volts line is still there or no? Interesting, our 3 volt line has disappeared. Oh, there it is. Okay, that's fine. And press the power button again. All right, still the same. No change. Let's continue to this guy, the mother of a chip. There he is. Okay. Okay, now let's bring the donor kebab. Well, one of them is already gone. Okay, there we go. fuck, that's hot. Just need to move it a little bit more. Better. Okay, let's plug in the power. Power is in. And press the power button. No. Okay. Check voltages are good. Okay. Trying to get it to turn on. My ground is not good. So we definitely don't have 3.3 now. Okay, I've got it. And the 5 volt. Just trying to get a damn ground, it's so difficult. Ah, fucking hell. Should just run a wire. Pressing the power button, I either don't get the 5 volts I need, or the power button is finally broken. Let me try shorting. Alright, so it's actually 5 volts, it's working. So 1 volt is there. I need to find a way to get a really, really good ground. One second, this is pissing me off. All right, finally. See if when we press the power button actually presses the power button or not. What is wrong with these probes, you wanker? Is that a fucking ground? Yes. Continuity? There is no continuity. What the hell? What do you get when you buy shitty wire? It's fucking... Okay. So you better fucking work then. Alright, the yellow one, fuck you, where are you? Hi! You're going straight in the bin. Okay, finally. Ground is ground. Wow, so difficult. Shit. Alright, voltage. Okay, voltage here, nothing here, nothing here. I guess that's their power button. Okay. Button works, okay. Let me just check one more thing. Okay, great. Okay. So I do know where the button is if I need to manually press it or short it. Okay. Ah, fuck, that was so difficult. Okay. Something so simple took me forever. Okay, voltage mode. Yes, voltage mode it is. Okay. Here. Okay, there we go. Okay, similar thing. So he used to come on. Not anymore. Just checks if I replace that chip with the same chip. The original one I removed was this one, which is... M3376A. Yeah, correct. And pins. Yeah, they look alright. Okay, no problem there. It's still not turning on. How about you? Yeah, they all look alright. Maybe I should just reflow just a little bit. You know, another thing, we don't need the backlight up and running, right? So we can remove that coil just to see. If the board will still attempt to boot without its backlight, backlight LCD screen backlight. Okay, still nothing, pressing the power button and... Okay, still nothing. No, it's still not coming on. Check our BIOS chip again, he's in happily. Yeah, I'm sure he is, just double check those pins. Okay, so nothing yet. We achieved nothing. We still have our 19 volts going in. Okay, still have our power button. Still got our 3 volts, and I believe the 5 volts will come on once I short that pin. Yep, and then it will turn off. So we get 1 volt, it will turn off about the CPU. So now these guys are not coming on anymore, unless I'm not checking them correctly. And the RAM comes on briefly, 1.2, and then dies. So let's put this chip back, because once I've removed this chip and put the other one in, once I swap this chip, I don't get the voltage anymore that I want on the two power rails for the CPU, I believe, or GT, the internal graphics, I'm not sure. Okay. Okay. And we get our voltage back on the on these coils. No. No, we don't. Well, because it's not plugged in, Dick. Okay. Yeah, now we get our voltage back. We can assume this chip is fine. MPK, let me remove these two guys. There is a monohelic power systems. One and two. and a 3. You tell me, Hako, what do I do with your tip? Okay, that's fine. Basically, I'm coming into the heat to help the solder and iron. Okay, that's the best. Now, let's bring in 1, 2, and 3. We need 3 donors. Who's willing to donate their body parts? Okay. Go. That's good. And the next one. Okay. This is how most, or I should say some, of the Apple techs that I know, that's how they repair the Macs. That is super duper hot. Let's wait for it. Same. Okay. You know what? We've been given free rein over this motherboard anyway to do whatever we want, so I want to look at somewhere. Let me see where I can start. The reason why I removed that, because there are some capacitors and other components lurking underneath them. Just want to make sure I didn't miss out anything. You see, a problem happens after it turns on. So in that case, let's look at these guys here. Let's remove this guy too now. Okay, let's do more. This is a touch. This is the SSD part. Okay, one more connector. One is more dangerous. Okay, that's all done. Now the last two. Yeah, that's the way I've been removing them. And then the last big giant one, maybe this one first. Okay. One last inspection, here we go. Okay, here we go. That's a MOSFET. Hi. Looks okay. Gate to ground. No problemo. Nah, I don't know what the issue is. Imagine it's just a BIOS issue the whole time. Yeah, giving up on this one. What if I have a bad charger all along? Same shit. No problems there. I can't believe it. Out of curiosity, do any of these guys get any power before they fully shut down? Nope, how about you? Just make sure I'm pressing the button correctly, yeah. Nothing. The BIOS pin number 1. How about the coil, which is currently in a limbo? Anyway, I don't think I can fix this, as I don't know the problem. I need a capacitor. Same pick of ferrets, but no, okay. Alright, I'm gonna end the video here. What a stupid video. See you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.